And finally tonight, here at InfoWars Nightly News, I want to give you the story behind the story. Or as Paul Harvey would say, the rest of the story. There's an article from Breitbart, and there's a lot of other publications breaking this down and going over it today, that President Obama is moving ahead with a push for basically carbon tax emissions on aircraft in this country. Now, we already have emission rules, but they want to basically regulate carbon dioxide that is put off. And by declaring that a toxic waste, they're able to tax it and able to shrink the size of engines. In fact, they're in the news now talking about commercial and also private aviation, the aircraft getting slower, things going in reverse because we have to cut our carbon by 20% just in the next few years and then by 50% in the next decade. We're talking about crippling industrial civilization and not having anything to replace it. But don't worry, government aircraft will be exempt from this, and President Obama has ordered the most massive new Air Force One in history, the biggest and the longest, and he personally just made that decision. Now, what's the rest of the story here? Well, everyone knows that for decades, insiders blew the whistle about NSA spying and bulk data collection. And the media spun it and said no such thing is happening. We also, for decades, heard that so many other government programs weren't taking place, and then later it would come out that they were taking place. There are countless examples of government and media working together to keep us in the dark. Until the early 1950s, we were told that there was no such thing as organized crime in this country. Everyone now knows that, of course, it was always going on, and not just Italian, but across the board. Everything from German to Irish to Jewish to Filipino, it's been going on. It's been happening. But this is part of the childlike state that they have tried to basically keep the population in for so long. Whether it's on the Patriot Act being used against citizens or illegal NSA spying. But the rest of the story here is weather modification. It has been well known since the 70s that Western governments, but also the Russians, could manipulate hurricanes, typhoons, could actually start hurricanes and typhoons. During Vietnam, Ben Livingston, the father of weather weapons, led squadrons in that would flood the Ho Chi Minh Trail. He could take a clear blue sky and turn it into huge thunderheads that would dump 2 feet of water in just a few hours.
My name is Ben Livingston. I'm the first person to ever see the cloud with the intention to cause it to do military damage. I know I can say that, and I did it several times before the next person did it.
Tell me what these clouds are we're looking at.
Well, these clouds were located up in the southern part of North Vietnam, and we needed to make rain down on the Ho Chi Minh Trail, Highway 1. But there weren't any real clouds around. There were a number. This was the end of the monsoon season, but there were a number of these small clouds that barely reached the freezing level, and by putting a small amount of silver iodide in there, we got them to collect and start to build. And as they built, we just worked on the largest tower in the group until in just a very short time. We had clouds that were...
You told me this cloud got 14 inches of...
This cloud, of course, this is all the same cloud.
In 1978, they had the Environmental Modification Convention outlawing the weaponization of these weather control systems. But again, you ask the average American about it, they don't know about it because, well, the media either ridicules it or doesn't cover it. Now, occasionally they do tell the truth. Here's ABC News, weather engineering in China. And it just goes into them clearing the skies for the 2008 Olympics. So those are just some of the examples. We also have NASA coming out a decade ago and then again last year and saying the Earth is between 20 and 30% more darker in the Northern Hemisphere than it was just a few decades ago. And that's not because the sun has really changed. It's because, as satellite images show, the condensation trails from jet aircraft are so numerous that they're blocking out the sun. But they're not just ice crystals. Some of them are real condensation trails. Others have had aluminum dioxide, barium salts, and even radioactive isotopes added. We have the U.S. Patent Office documents on this. A globalist won a Nobel Prize back in the early 90s for coming up with the idea of a sunscreen to protect the Earth from the sun. The truth is, it's a giant secret global program that's partially declassified and going on a mass scale. So they're trying to restrict engine size and slow down jet aircraft and make us go backwards. To quote, save us from carbon dioxide that plants breathe and then put off oxygen from, while ignoring the fact that they're spraying the skies with aluminum that's deadly for plants, animals, you name it, not to mention all the other chemicals. And what's crazy is, they have national media come out and say, I'm a conspiracy theory that we're engaged in made-up garbage when we're covering real stuff that's been happening, real things that are unfolding. It's just like the Manhattan Project. In today's numbers, it cost $4 or $5 trillion, they estimate. It cost tens of billions at the time. They kept it secret for 5 years from the public, and there was over 50,000 people closely associated with it. Well, they've kept this quasi-secret, and then all they do is ridicule people when they talk about it. When the TPP was being set up to hand over our sovereignty and merge the North American Union with the Asian Union, I began to cover it. And they would have national media say that we were making it up and we're insane. When we covered other UN treaties, like the Rio de Janeiro Agenda 21 from 1992, they would say it's insane, doesn't exist, even though we have the public documents. Now they admit, though, yeah, these treaties do put us under international corporate control. They will make the rules about what happens in the U.S. Monsanto now goes to the World Trade Organization to stop labeling in the U.S. You see, they go outside to these other bodies where our national sovereignty has been transferred to. We need to have a serious discussion, a bipartisan, across-the-board discussion about weather modification. Listen. They still say the SR-71, in service in the mid-50s, is the fastest plane in the world, flying upwards of Mach 5. Ladies and gentlemen, they've got aircraft that have been classified that are much, much faster. And that just shows you how we're in this frozen technological development system that the Bilderberg Group wants of negative growth. They want to freeze us in a dark age while the elites have access to these technological reservations and life extension technologies, and that they get to basically ascend. So they're stealing our culture, our civilization, our brain trust. Exactly what Eisenhower warned us about, a technological elite in control of the military-industrial complex taking over.
An opposite danger, that public policy could itself become the captive of a scientific, technological elite.
And that's because we now know that L.L. Lemnitzer, the Joint Chiefs of Staff chairman, and others came to him basically with the larger globalist plan to be part of it, and Eisenhower rebuked it and said it was horrible. Well, unfortunately, this group has gone from being prominent through the Rockefeller and Carnegie Foundations and actually funding Hitler because the U.S. wouldn't fully adopt it. Hitler then failed, and that plan has come back here to the United States. It's very, very sophisticated, but if you're aware of it, it can be beat. But it's all about covert. We bring it out in the light. They said Bilderberg Group didn't exist. Now they admit it exists. On so many things, they want to just end debate by saying it isn't happening. But if you just research it, don't Google chemtrails, because that's just what the lay term. You look at weather modification, geoengineering, basically terraforming here on the planet. You'll get thousands of university reports, Department of Energy programs. It's going on. It's going on big time. They even put it in kids' textbooks now to condition them and admit it's happening, but tell them it's good. To adults, they go, no, it doesn't exist. This is how they condescend to us. So am I worried about carbon dioxide? Absolutely not. Am I worried about geoengineering and genetic engineering and all these other crazy super science fiction stuff? You bet I am. Well, great job to Dave and I and the rest of the crew this evening. That's it for this transmission. I hope you'll get this video and the other important pieces tonight that we post to InfoWars.com tomorrow and get it out to your friends and family and go research the claims I've made here for yourself, because it all comes down to you. If you don't stand up to this, we will be completely enslaved. All right, that's it. Have a great evening.
The knowledge of the ancients, tried and true, trusted herbs and extracts fused with the latest nutraceutical science. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. For the last 2 years, our team has been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to develop the ultimate nutraceutical formulation. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. For a limited time, get 25% off on this introductory offer. Visit AncientDefense.com or call 888-253-3139. AncientDefense.com.
You are watching the InfoWars Nightly News, which airs 7 p.m. Central at InfoWarsNews.com, and your support is helping us defend liberty worldwide.